Bang, Neeves Knives. I'm Jared, and today we have a bunch of knives. We're going to check out some of them for the first time on the channel. This is from Cory Dunlap. Kara actually picked this up from Blade Show. We're just going to take a quick look at it. Beautiful fat carbon fiber. This is pink fat carbon fiber. It looks really, really good. It pops in the light. You see you have a hand set, and this is obviously a handmade knife. You see Cory Dunlap's logo right there. Now, this is the first knife we've gotten from him or featured on the channel. So, yeah, and I got to say, this thing is extremely, extremely well done. I actually like this size of the handle because the size of it, it's really compact, but yet even my pinky has a comfortable spot. It's kind of weird, even though it's such a small handle. You know, I can really choke up and really squeeze down on this, and this thing is precision. It is so, you can't even see an edge bevel. And he is a knife sharpener, so yeah, really, really well done. Really well done sheath too. And yeah, definitely check him out. I'm sure he has an Instagram page. Like I said, this is the first time we've ever had anything from him. Next is the VOSTEED knives. This is going to be really quick. I did a video and I posted it the other day, and for some reason something happened with it. I don't know what. So we have the VOSTEED raccoon. You guys know, great button lock, great knife. I personally really like the raccoon. I think it's very comfortable in the hand. It has a beautiful blade shape. The whole thing is just, it's a great, great knife for EDC. Well done. Then the grind, which is a Scandi grind knife. So this is the VOSTEED grind. And I gotta say, holy cow, sharp. That's one thing with Scandi grinds, man, because the entire grind is the bevel, the edge bevel. It is very, very sharp. Now, some people are gonna argue that there's not a real Scandi micro bevel. Well, I can't see a micro bevel. And even if there is one, what does it matter? What difference does it make if this thing has a microscopic micro bevel? Like, what? It's only going to make it tough. That's it. That's the only thing it's going to do, because the sharpness is insane. So it's not making it, you know, more or less sharp. So the only thing it's going to do is maybe toughen it up just a little bit if there is a little micro bevel. But anyways, micarta scales. Now, I will say they didn't take my recommendations. My recommendations were fix the sharpening choil and make it a little bit bigger, a little bit broader, and a little bit bigger. And I think if they would have done that, this thing would be even better. It's still really good, and they do a good job on their crossbar locks. They have a great detents, so lots of leverage there from the flick, and good access to the crossbar lock. Very easy to drop down. It is on bearings. You also have this fuller that you can flick off of if you want. But 14C, 28M blade steel, same as the raccoon. And yeah, the VOSTEED grind is up for pre-order if you want to check this out, or if you want to get this. I forget the date that they're going to start delivering them, but it's soon though. So if the pre-order's open, what it is, you pre-order, buy it. You're not going to have to wait months or anything like that. You just have to wait, you know, a few weeks or something, or a couple weeks. Next is the Thunderbird. And I know I featured this in that video, and I don't know what happened with it. It just like kind of crapped out at like the two and a half minute mark. But anyways, yes, this thing is awesome, but it is sold out at the moment. So I'm not going to talk too much about it, but it's an S35VN bladed. There we go. S35VN blade drop point. Japanese style tanto. That's what I'm going to call it. It does have a secondary edge or secondary tip, but it's very, very, very minimal. But it has a dual grind, beautiful blade shape, beautiful grind, great action, and it is super duper fidgety. Great front flipper. I love this type of front flipper, how it angles over right there. So it's very, very comfortable to flick. Anyways, hopefully these things are back in stock very soon. Next. Okay, now this one is something special. This is probably the best box I've seen from the Monthly Knife Club. So if you joined the Monthly Knife Club and you did, I think, the premium one or the $120 one, you will get the Drop Bear in titanium. Ooh, my thing. Titanium and LC200N. Now, this is going, I think, for like $160 normally. So if you were part of the club, you'd only pay $120 for this, and this is what you're gonna get. So everything will be linked down in the description. If you want to join the monthly knife club box, this will be your knife that you will get. And if you don't know, it has the clutch lock, which is an adjustable adjustable crossbar, comes with a stronger spring and then a weaker spring, and then it also has holes where you can adjust it to make the tension stronger or lighter. They're perfect right out of the box. I personally do like the thicker spring just a little bit more, but yeah, they're so good. I absolutely love the Drop Bear. It's one of the best knives of the year so far. So, titanium milled pocket clip. It's actually a deep carry plus milled pocket clip, but then this one has the titanium scales with the anodized and then this beautiful stone wash. It almost looks like crystals. Then the other tier, the tier two, is the Damn Designs Invictus. So this one would be $55, and the knife is an $80 knife. So here's all the specs. You can just read it really quick. I gotta say, this one's really good too. Amazing ergonomics. I mean, I'm squeezing hard on it, and I can just tell, like, I could really bear down on this for a long period of time. Great access to lock bar, very comfortable disengagement. Super duper smooth, awesome flipper. This flipper is well gimped, well positioned. I know it doesn't look like you're gonna have a ton of leverage, but this goes up and then over, so it actually does have a lot of leverage. Nice, comfortable flipper tab, very easy to flip, great tension. I would call this damn near a perfect detent. Yeah, probably, I'd probably call it, yeah, it's a perfect detent. No, it's a 5. 14C 28M blade steel, fantastic blade steel choice. Sharp edge on plunge grind, it could be better, but you got a couple sharpenings there. It is relatively thin behind the edge. Beautiful drop point blade, so it's going to be extremely useful. Then you have a deep carry inset clip that's also reversible. That's awesome. So this thing's pretty well done. And also, if you didn't notice, the liners are inset. So the liners are all inset all the way around, which is really, really cool. You have a hidden lanyard pin back here, or hidden lanyard hole. The pivot looks really good with this octagon shape. So yeah, either one of these I think is an amazing, you're getting a good deal. So whether this, you get the $50 to $5 one, fantastic deal, or the $120, $119 one, an amazing deal. And then we have this Rike neck knife. Now, this does come in premium options and budget options. This one's the budget option. So this is a steel casing, but they have titanium casings with M390. But it has the gears in there. You pop it off of the, because it has like a magnetic detent right there. I think it's magnets. Or no, it actually has a regular detent. So it has a detent ball and magnets, it looks like. Anyway, so you pop that. And then you spin it around and you see the gears actually work. And it spins the blade around and then you lock it in place. Now you have just a little edge. Now this one's only 8CR, but you know, it's just a little cool little neck knife for opening packages or whatever. You know, like I said, it does come in premium ones. It kind of looks like a bug or something like that. But yeah, it's pretty cool. You can see the stop pin right there. So as it comes around, you can see, bam. Locks in place, the little internal stop pin. So yeah, it's pretty cool how it works on gears, has a magnet and, you know, a little detent, a little snappy action. And then this, you know, I guess you could use this as a bottle opener maybe, or, you know, whatever, yeah, a little pry tool or something. Now, I know I spoke about this in that other video too, but just really quick, the Sitivien S T152 K110 steel. They did a really good job with this one. Woo! It is very, very smooth. Man, they did a killer job with this one. Nice sharpening tool and plunge grind, beautiful satin finish. Love the blade shape. Very ergonomic. You can, you know, do the trigger pull grip. And yeah, you could bear down on it really good. Good access to the lock bar. Very, very smooth. Centering is, it's a little off, but it's not that big of a deal. This is, it's close, and I have been messing with it a lot. And this is like a $30 knife. K110 is basically D2 steel. So G10 scale, steel liner lock. And yeah, this one is one of their good ones for sure. And for only $30, man, you can't beat that.